Glucometer. Preparing your meter. Have the following things ready when you check blood sugar level. Glucometer, test strips, lancing device, sterile lancets. Coding the glucometer. Check the code on the test strip vial before inserting the test strip. Code numbers are used to calibrate your meter with the test strips you are using to obtain accurate test results. You must code the meter before using it for the first time and then every time you change to another vial of test strips. Remove a test strip from its vial. Do not bend, cut, or modify the test strip in any way. Use each test strip immediately after removing it from the vial. Hold the meter as shown and insert the test strip into the test port. Make sure the three contact bars are facing you. Push the test strip in as far as it will go. Do not bend the test strip. Test strips are for single use only. Never reuse a test strip. After the startup test screen appears, the meter will display the code from your last test. Match the code on the meter with the code on the test strip vial by using the keys on the glucometer. The display will advance to the screen with a flashing blood drop icon. The meter is now ready to perform a blood sugar test. Preparing your sample site. Before you test blood sugar, ask the patient to wash hands thoroughly, rinse and dry. Lancing and sampling from fingertip. Remove the blue cap of the lancet by snapping it off. Insert a sterile lancet into the lancing device. Insert the lancet into the holder and push in firmly. Twist the protective disc until it separates from the lancet and save the disc for later use. Do not twist the lancet. Replace the blue cap by snapping it back on. Adjust the depth setting. The lancing device may have several puncture depth settings. The smaller numbers are for a shallower puncture and the larger numbers are for a deeper puncture. Shallower punctures work for children and most adults. Deeper punctures work well for people with thick or calloused skin. Twist the blue cap until the correct setting appears. A shallower puncture may be less painful. Try a shallower setting first and increase the depth until you find it deep enough to get a blood sample of at least 1 microliter. Slide the control button back on the lancing device until it clicks. If it does not click, the control button may have already been locked back and ready to spring for site puncture when you inserted the lancet. Hold the lancing device firmly against the side of the finger. Press the release button. Remove the lancing device from the finger. Gently squeeze or massage the fingertip until a round drop of blood forms on the fingertip. If the blood smears or runs, do not use that sample. Dry the area and gently squeeze another drop of blood or puncture a new site. Prepare to apply the sample. Keeping your finger extended and steady, move the meter and test strip towards the blood drop. Do not apply blood on the top of the test strip. Do not hold the meter and test strip underneath the blood drop. This may cause blood to run into the test port and damage the meter. Line up the test strip with the blood drop so that the narrow channel on the edge of the test strip is almost touching the edge of the blood drop. Gently touch the channel to the edge of the blood drop. Wait for the confirmation window to fill completely. The blood drop will be drawn into the narrow channel and the confirmation window should fill completely. When the confirmation window is full, this means you have applied enough blood. Read your result on the meter. The blood sugar level appears on the display along with the unit of measure and the date and time of the test. Blood sugar results are automatically stored in the meter's memory. Once you have read the result, you may turn the meter off by removing the test strip, removing the used lancet, remove the lancing device cap by snapping it off, cover the exposed lancet tip before removing the lancet. Place the lancet protective disc on a hard surface. Push the lancet tip into the disc. Remove the lancet and place it in a container for sharp objects. Replace the cap. Disposing of the used lancet and test strip. It is important to discard the used lancet carefully after use to avoid unintended lancet stick injuries. Used test strips and lancets are biohazardous waste. Be sure to follow your local regulations for proper disposal.